Hey there, it's Laura here for Heffy Doodle, and in today's video, I'll be creating a slimline seagull beach cart featuring You Go Go and a little shellfish. I'm starting out by stamping images from Oceans of Love, You Go Go, and a little shellfish on some Copic-friendly cardstock using Memento Textil Black ink. Next, I'm coloring my images using the Copic sketch markers. For the wings of my seagulls, I use some shades of neutral grays. Then I'm using YR09, YR04, and YR02 for their feet and beak. And then to add some shading to the feathers, I'm using N0 and the colorless blender. Next, for the red crab, I'm using R29, R24, and R22. Then I am using Y19, Y18, and Y13 for the starfish. And for the seaweed, I'm using YG09, YG06, and YG03. As you may have noticed, I used my Misty stamping platform to stamp all of these images at once, since that saves me a lot of time. For the shell, I'm using RV14, RV13, and RV11. For the sandcastle, I'm using E35, E33, and E31. Now that I colored all of these images, it's time to cut them out using the coordinating dies. I also went ahead and I cut the smallest rectangle from the new stitched slimline trio die cut set from Heffy Doodle. And then I'm going to go ahead and die cut the little or the slimline die that cuts out three little windows. I'm using Heffy Doodle low tech memo tape to mask off parts of my slimline rectangle since I'll be doing some ink blending. For the sand piece of my scene, I'm using antique linen distress oxide ink. And I'm going in with some watercolor splatters just to add some extra detail to this card. I'm using some watercolors from the Kuretake Gonzai Tambi, or whatever you pronounce it, watercolor set. And I like to mix that with a lot of water, and then I can just kind of splatter those little droplets all around. And if you want some darker splatters, then you just have to use less water. Next, I'm going to add some color to the frame for my scene. I'm using some masking tape just to hold my piece in place while I add the color. I'm using tumble glass and peacock feathers distress oxide ink, and I'm creating a gradient. So I'm starting out with my lightest color on the top, and then I use the peacock feathers on the bottom, and then I just switch back and forth between those two colors in order to create a nice gradient. The reason why I am suddenly moving on to this piece is because my splatters of the little sand portion needed to dry before I could move on to the sky. And I'll be creating three different little scenes using this die cut set. I really like this slimline die cut set because it comes with this die that creates the three little frames. So it's perfect to create fun little scenes or just to do any other fun technique that you have in mind. Now that I added color to the frame, it's time to move on to the other piece. So I'm going to add some more of that antique linen to my centerpiece. Also going to add some of those watercolor splatters to that. And then once that was dry, I moved on to the sky piece. Or the ocean piece, actually. This is not a sky, but this is the ocean piece. So I'm using Salty Ocean Distress Oxide ink, and just like I did for my sand portion, I'm going in with some of that watercolor paint. This time I'm using a dark blue shade, and I like to add splatters using a lot of water, but then I also like to add splatters using a little bit less water, just so you can kind of see the difference between those two colors. I made sure that was completely dry, and then I prepped my cardstock using my We Are Memory Keepers powder tool before stamping my sentiment using Versamark ink. I'm sprinkling on opaque bright white embossing powder from WOW, and then I am heat setting that until it's melted completely. I'm using my Longfang glue tube to add some liquid adhesive to my frame so I can adhere that on top of my ink blended ocean and beach scene. I also adhered that little piece of seaweed over there, and now it's just time to assemble everything. So I'm using some foam squares to adhere my seagulls, the little shell, the lobster, and then I'm also going to adhere all of the other elements. I'm going to adhere my finished piece to a slimline note card that I cut to 3 inches by 8 inches. I'm using some foam tape to adhere the ink blended piece to my note card. For the base of my slimline card, I used oyster shell colored cardstock from Heffy Doodle. Finally, I'm going in with my Crafter's Companion Sparkle Pen to add a little bit of glitter here and there. And of course, I'm also using glossy accents just to add some extra dimension and shine to my finished card. So there you go, that's it for now. Thank you so much for stopping by. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the notification bell below. I will see you very soon. Bye-bye.